Congratulations to the class of 2020 on your graduation. Hi, I'm attorney Gloria Allred, a proud graduate of the Philadelphia High School for Girls in 1959. I grew up in a little row house in Philadelphia. My parents only had an eighth grade education and no money. But I got a great education at Girls High, and they taught me important values to stand up for the rights of women and girls. And this has changed my life. I'm so proud of all of the women who have had the courage to speak out. Rich, famous, powerful men have to understand there are rules, there are boundaries. They must respect those boundaries. This has got to end, and it needs to end right now.
There is a war on women. Women depend on me to be strong and to assert and protect their rights.
Joining us now,
civil rights attorney.
Please welcome Gloria Allred.
She talked about sexual harassment, race, women's rights, when nobody wanted to talk about it.
He thinks no more women will come forward. He is very wrong.
Power only understands power. Fighting injustice is a commitment that I made many years ago.
She understands what we are experiencing based on what she had experienced herself.
What happened to me was absolutely shocking. To this day, I can't even think about it.
Is this getting too personal?
My commitment to women comes from my own life experience.
I have this venom toward Gloria Allred. Wherever you see Allred, you know somebody's lying.
That's assault! That is assault!
I think Gloria enjoys conflict. This makes her a great champion for us.
People say she's loud, she's got an ego, she must just love the camera.
She's trying to turn women into men!
I think secretly you envy women and you fear them!
I just say, haven't you met any men like that?
You should use these resources to arrest these fathers who are not paying their child support.
If it wouldn't have been for Gloria, Nicole would have always been just that person on the gurney.
We deserve to know if Mr. Cosby is a sexual predator.
This is not state law as we see it.
Hopefully next year you can issue the marriage license.
That can help people evolve from being a victim.
'Cause I'm on fire, fire.
To becoming a survivor.
Fire.
To becoming a fighter for change.
Women are now empowered, and they will never be silent again.
This is
where the revolution begins. Class of 2020, you may be disappointed that you're not having an in-person graduation, but you have something even more important. You are making herstory because you are the class of 2020. And this is what I mean. Hi, this is attorney Gloria Allred, and with me is my friend Gert Crawford. We're here to celebrate the 100th anniversary of women winning the right to vote in the United States. And that is called suffrage. It is the addition of the 19th Amendment to the United States Constitution. Don't ever let anyone say we were given the right to vote. We were never given it. We fought and we won it. We fought from 1848 to 1920. We lobbied, we picketed. Many were arrested by people in uniforms similar to this. Often the police would handcuff and also take the women to jail. And there many of the feminists fasted, refused to eat, were forcibly fed, and some died sacrificing their lives so women could enjoy the right to vote. Honor their sacrifice by voting this November for candidates who support women's rights, choice, and the passage of the Equal Rights Amendment to the United States Constitution. Our work is unfinished. We want you to be the change that you wish to see in the world. And you can do that by voting in November. Thank you. I'm a lawyer, but you don't have to be one to help win change. At Rosa Parks' funeral, United States Senator Barack Obama reminded us that Ms. Parks had, quote, held no public office, she wasn't a wealthy woman, she didn't appear in the society pages, and yet, when the history of this country is written, it is this small, quiet woman whose name will be remembered long after the names of senators and presidents have been forgotten, end quote. That's because she was, as Michigan Governor Jennifer Granholm called her, quote, an heroic warrior for equality, end quote. You too can be an heroic warrior for equality. Even if you're not rich or famous, you too can make a choice to make a difference. United States Senator Hillary Clinton reminded us that we too can have a Rosa Parks moment. But I would urge you to have a Rosa Parks moment every day. Challenge yourself and challenge others to stand up for what is right. Speak up, fight back, and seek positive change. Others will follow your lead, and ultimately, you'll come out a winner. Be the change you wish to see in the world. And now, class of 2020, go out and celebrate.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. But there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest, you can beat the world.
Congratulations, class of 264. I am so proud that you've made it all this way. Now I want you to go out to the world and make your mark. Happy graduation.
Greetings, 264. I'm sorry we're not together at graduation in person with each other. I would surely be in tears. I feel connected to so many of you. We've spent class times, lunch times, after school times, club times, trip times, and contest times together. I value the hours we've spent in deep conversations, debating, arguing, and laughing. I appreciate our honest and sincere relationships. I hope we can sustain them after you've gone your own ways. As a class 264, you can be lazy, procrastinators, creative, brilliant, sympathetic, loving, and giving. And most of all, always real. 264, you don't sugarcoat anything. What we see is what we get, if we bug you enough for it. I wish you all the best, 264. Congratulations on your graduation from one of the best schools in the city of Philadelphia. You have left your mark on Girls High and on my heart. Now it's time to make your mark on the world. Go get them, 264. Straighten this crazy world out, please.
Greetings, class of 2020. It's Mr. Edwards. I'd like to say congratulations on your graduation. Although I was not at Girls High very long, a little less than 5 months, I did have a great experience there and enjoyed my experience with you seniors. I wish you the best of luck in your future endeavors. I wish you all the best, and hopefully this year is just a stepping stone for you and not something that you feel is something that holds you back. Wishing you all the best and continued success. Take care. it was a truly a pleasure to work with you all that I did get to work with. Take care and have a great time.
Class of 2020, this is Mrs. Buru. Today marks an important milestone in your lives. You have worked extremely hard to get to this point, but I want to tell you that graduations only mark the beginning of life's journey. You have already seen the challenges in this world. Very soon, it will be up to you to come up with solutions. The solutions don't have to be very complicated. You have already seen simple things like staying home, washing hands, covering our mouths, which we have all done, have actually saved lives. So therefore, in your life, please look for the simple things that you could do to impact your life and the lives of others. Congratulations, class of 2020. And please stop holding up all the tissues. Have a wonderful day and God bless.
Congratulations to the 264th graduating class of the Philadelphia High School for Girls. This is an exciting time for you as you embark on your future. It is also important for you to know that the intangible spirit of the Philadelphia High School for Girls crosses the miles, crosses the generations, and will support you in your future journey. My grandmother graduated in the June 1913 class. She went on to have a career as an elementary school teacher, teaching first grade. She always said that teaching children to read enabled them to reach their full potential. She was excited when she learned that I was going to go to the Philadelphia High School for Girls as well. Our family established a graduation award in her memory, to be given to a graduate who is planning to study early childhood or elementary education. The legacy of our family continues with my daughter being a graduate of the 233rd graduating class of the Philadelphia High School for Girls. So as you embark on your future, remember the intangible spirit of the Philadelphia High School for Girls that crosses the generations and crosses the miles will support you in your future endeavors. Wink it, qui, say wink it.
Hello, this is Mr. Sickage. Congratulations, Philadelphia High School for Girls 2019-2020 graduating class. Oh, the places you will go. Oh, the successes you will have. Congratulations.
Congratulations and good luck, girls. Take care. Stay safe. We miss you and we love you.
Congratulations, 264, on your 2020 graduation. My name is Marsherie Wright from the class of 2001-245. I know you guys were faced with a new norm of remote distance learning and your senior class activities were canceled. I would like you to forever cherish the other fun and sister bond activities that you did complete in that big building at Broad and Ollie with the pink marble hallway. I wish you all much success and luck in your next adventures. And remember, girls' high girls are everywhere. Congratulations, 264.
To my sisters of the 264, the class of 2020. As you walk from the pink marble halls into your greatness, always remember that you never walk alone. You were guided by the spirit of the ancestors, Jesse Redmond Fawcett, Pauline Oberdorfer Minor, Lisa Aversa Richette, C. Dolores Tucker, B.B. Moore Campbell, and Leslie Esdale Banks, among many, many other accomplished alumni. Your path was cleared by Gloria Bloom Allred, Judith S. Roden, Shirley Clark Franklin, Erica Alexander, Jill Scott, and Princess Garrett. Greatness is your legacy. Now is the time to make your own history. Wink it, Kise, wink it, forever. Welcome to our sisterhood.
Hi, 264, class of 2020. Big congratulations coming to you from 227, class of 1983. I wanted to share with you one of my favorite quotes that motivated me through college and my early career. Shoot for the moon. If you don't make it, you'll still be amongst the stars. Finally, stay strong, dream big, and be fearless. Go, 264.
My dear Girls High seniors, congratulations to you on your graduation. It's been a great pleasure and honor to teach many of you, sometimes twice. I remember when a lot of you started in biology class as a little freshman, and again in your junior year, meeting you again and seeing how much you've grown. And I can't wait to see what else is out there for the rest of your life. Please come back and visit us and tell us your success stories, and we want to hear the awesome things that are happening. And again, congratulations to you and best wishes.
Greetings to the 264th graduating class of my alma mater, the Philadelphia High School for Girls. This is Councilmember Catherine Gilmore Richardson, class of 245. Congratulations on reaching this major milestone in your life. You have persevered through incredibly challenging times to make it to this moment. Always remember, you are a Girls High girl. You are prepared for the challenges ahead, and you are destined for greatness. You learned a very valuable lesson this senior year, and that's perseverance. Never, ever give up on your goals and your dreams. Always remember, when things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, Rest if you must, but don't you quit. Congratulations, 264.
Congratulations, everyone. We are all so proud of you. I want you to know it was both a privilege and an honor to teach you at Girls High. It was a special time. Your hard work moved me to no end, those of you that took the dance classes. You were so ready for your performance. You were so beautiful. I was the one who was privileged to get to see you dance every day. I feel so saddened by the fact that your family and friends didn't get a chance to see your beauty on the stage. I hope you'll share it with them in your homes. Despite these challenging and very unusual times, I sincerely hope you all will persevere and continue to work toward both your career and personal dreams, and hopefully they can merge and everything will be well. I wish you all the very best, and again, congratulations.
Greetings, class of 264. I am so excited and proud of you. My name is Michelle Jemani, and I'm part of the 232nd class to graduate from Girls High. It was a long time ago, don't try to calculate. Anyway, from one sister to another, I'd like to share two things. One is follow your dreams, and I really mean that. You can be anything you want to be, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Listen to that inner voice. It will guide you. And oftentimes we really know what we need to do. The second thing is, keep in touch with your sisters. You are now part of this wonderful sisterhood. And I really cherish my 232 sisters. We still hang out, we still get together. We go to dinner, there've been brunches for, we went to Vegas for one of our high school reunions. And then just recently for our 30s reunion, we went to Jamaica, and it was such a wonderful time, and I really appreciate these ladies. So again, congratulations to you. This is your special day. Enjoy it, because you earned it.
Come on! 1996, and I'm a member of the class of 240. Listen, 2020 hasn't been easy on any of us. It's been challenging. I know for you all, it's been isolating. There have been moments of disappointment, lots of despair. It's been hard. But like 2020, I believe that you all are unique, resilient, and full of potential. Congratulations on this educational milestone that you have accomplished. I look forward to hearing about all the great things you are doing out in the world. I know you all will be running Fortune 500 companies. You will be starting your own businesses. You will be running for office. You will be teaching our babies. You will be finding cures to diseases. You guys will be doing things that some of us would never have imagined doing. I want you to know that you have a support system. You have a network. You have a bunch of sisters behind you, rooting you on. We are chanting 264, 264, 264. We are so proud of you. Know that we are here. Know that we love you. Know that we are supporting you. And no matter where you go, there is always a Girls High Girl. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Boy, you have had quite a year. I'm Mary Schmidt Campbell, president of Spelman College and a member of the Philadelphia High School for Girls, Grade 208. I know these have been trying times, but I'll tell you something. Graduating from Girls High School, you are ready. You're ready academically. You know how to think critically. You know how to analyze. You do well with complex ideas. You are ready. You're ready also because you've learned how to forge really great relationships with each other. You know how to take care of each other, to be dependent on each other, and to look out for each other. And you'll take those relationships with you wherever you go for the rest of your life. I know that you're feeling that you're walking out into a world that's really uncertain. And it is. But one thing that is certain is that you are well prepared being a Girls High Girl. And you will find that wherever you are, no matter how many years pass between now and the future, you will always find strong ties back to the Philadelphia High School for Girls. So go out there, be well, be safe, and know that we're sending our love and our great faith in what we know will be a wonderful future for you.
Whoa, spirit.
264.
I'm Stephanie from class 253.
I'm Regina from 247.
I know it's been tough on you guys getting through everything with COVID, but just know that you have a lot of people behind you guys. You guys are resilient. You made it. You got through it. You got this. Let's keep going.
In all circumstances, remember to stay in prayer. Learn from your mistake, but keep moving forward. Mm-hmm. Believe in yourself. Always trucking forward. And always maintaining integrity in all that you do.
That's
but
right.
Congratulations!
Woo! Girls, woo! High girls! Y'all got this! Keep going!
Hi, this is Mr. A. This is what I look like when I go out of the house nowadays. So I'd like to wish all of you like a happy graduation. Hope all of you do well in your college endeavors or wherever you're going after this. Don't forget to all of us back here at Philadelphia High School for Girls. Have a great graduation.
Takes a moment to break a butterfly on a wheel. That's when you hear an angel cry. It takes a heartbeat to bring someone back to life, and then you feel that it's all been worthwhile. Voices inside me keep guiding the way. Someone who loves me, I still hear them say, you can be anything, anything, anything you dreamed of. You can be anything, anything, anything you dreamed of, anything you dreamed of. Pick me up and wipe away my tears, always there to drive away my fears. I'd call you late at night, so close to giving in. You took the time to care and lift me up again. Lessons you taught me, I'll never forget.
To my wonderful daughters of the 264th graduating class, 4 years ago, you made a very conscious decision to attend the Philadelphia High School for Girls. At that time, as your principal, it was clear to me that you decided you wanted to be a member of the only public high school in the city of Philadelphia that demonstrated more than 170 years of support for young women as they found their place in society. I must say you made a very wise decision. The growth you have made has better prepared you for the world and the person you are becoming. Your family and friends have also assisted in allowing you to determine the values you will place on yourself and those around you to live up to your life standards. You have had 4 years of participating in Girls High traditions, inclusive of county fairs, songs of the season, daddy-daughter dances, freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior days that I'm sure you have had fond memories of and that will last you a lifetime. No one, however, could have prepared you for what has taken place during this your senior year. The COVID-19 pandemic, the protests, the unrest in our country, and still you have proven you have the tenacity, the resilience, and the persistence to complete and have completed your classes and continue to be Girls High strong. I am certain all of these events will have an impact on your life as you continue to seek excellence in all that you will do when you attend the college of your choice and or the university and as you work to determine your career goal. Your fortitude will continue to allow you to seek excellence in all that you do. Remember not to let these or anything or anyone stand in your way and be a barrier for any of your life accomplishments. I cannot tell you how proud I am of each and every one of you. You made it. You now are a graduate of the Philadelphia High School for Girls, representing the 264th class. My sisters in the 215th class applaud you. Everyone knows you would have made it, and especially me. When you have your very first class reunion or before, please reach out to me and invite me. I'd like to attend. Know that I wish you all the success in all of your future endeavors, and remember our school's motto, "She conquers who conquers herself." In all of the years of the graduates of our school, you have truly proven, maybe more than any other graduating student in recent times, that you believe, have lived up to, and are an example of a young woman who could have and will continue to be proven as a Girls High girl. Remember to give back to our school when you can and honor your patriotic duty to our society. And so I now charge you to go out into the world, my daughters, and now my sisters, the class of 2020, and conquer the world. I will love you and miss you forever. Remember these my words, your forever principal, Dr. Moore. Thank you.
To the Girls High Class of 2020, to the young ladies of the Class of 264, as life opens up a brand new door, although you can't know what's in store, may you always remember and never forget the best for you has not come yet. As you move ahead during these uncertain times, keep your head up and continue to shine. Step out in faith with fortitude, and in all you do, bring a positive attitude. Ladies, don't let anyone define you. Write your own story. Sincerely, Sadina Williams, Girls High Class of 1983-227.
Congratulations to the 264th graduating class of Girls High School. I'm Hilda Bacon, and I'm here with some of my classmates from the Mighty 207. We graduated together 56 years ago, and today we're together to say congratulations to you.
Hi, I'm Julie Liebman, and I feel your pain. We too had a horrendous experience in 12th grade, which changed everything for us. The assassination of President Kennedy. We grieved together and we healed together. And as a result, we formed a very special bond that we still feel today. Cherish your bonds. Congratulations on your graduation.
I'm Franny Farmer Smith. You may not control all the events that happen to you, but you can decide not to be reduced by them. Maya Angelou. Congratulations, graduates. I know that you will step into the next part of your journey with courage, intelligence, and love, and that you will help make the world a better place for all. Celebrate and be proud.
Hi, I'm Julie Hirsch-Waxman. This is definitely a surreal time making for a unique graduation. Wishing you well as you begin your next journey and know your Girls High School classmates and alumni are with you, just as mine are with me today.
Hello, this is Phyllis Hoagland Allen speaking. It's the obstacles that life places in front of us that makes us stronger once these obstacles are overcome. And you must always remember, inside of every woman is a warrior waiting to be released. We're very proud of you and we want to wish you congratulations for all of your accomplishments and in all your future endeavors. We were friends then, we're friends now, so cherish the friendships you have developed over the last 4 years. They're wonderful. And we want to close with wink it, we say wink it.
Thank you.
Greetings, my name is Maria Rowe and I am a Girls High graduate of the class of 235. To the class of 264, I want to congratulate you on your graduation for a job well done. You worked hard, persisted, and persevered to get to this point. Although things didn't come out the way we were expecting, your graduation is a historical moment that will have lasting memories. We know that change can be difficult, but we also know that with change comes possibilities. My little sisters, be encouraged because the best is yet to come. Congratulations!
Congratulations!
Congratulations, my sister graduates of the 264th class of the Philadelphia High School for Girls. I am Amina Josie Turner, born Elaine Jacqueline Josie of the 216th class of GHS. My graduation date was June 16, 1972, and in 1968, the 216th class was considered the largest and most diverse in our school's history. My mother, the late Reverend Dorothy Johnson Josie, graduated one of 30 Negroes in June of 1946. And while there, she met my godmother, the late C. Dolores Tucker, the first woman to serve as the Commonwealth Secretary of State. Years later, I married a North Carolinian and soon discovered that one of my husband's favorite cousins had graduated 2 years prior to me at GHS. Like so many of our alumni, we are all daughters of distinction within our own spheres of influence, all because of the Girls High experience. I believe that it was the academic freedom at GHS within the context of high expectations that developed young women, not defined by men, but by the synergy of their own academic inquiry. As you move into your next chapter, it will become apparent that Girls High prepared you with the investigative tools, analytical techniques, and a problem-solving acumen that will allow you to compete comfortably within any discipline of your choosing. It also taught you negotiating, advocacy, time management, and goal-setting skills, lifetime tools for times of certainty and uncertainty. I will always remember the impact that the pink marble halls at Broad and Olive Streets had and has continued to have upon my life as a Girls High girl. Remember your friendships, favorite teachers, county fair, and those memories that made you a Girls High girl. And above all, remember to support our alma mater. For GHS forever, Godspeed 264th.
Philadelphia High School for Girls, class of 2022, 6-4. This is Jill Scott. Congratulations on your graduating. Congratulations, women. You are necessary and so, so valuable. Your minds are going to take this place to the next level, and we need you. The whole country needs you. The whole world needs you. This is not pressure, this is destiny. Hail to our alma mater, our glory be our name. Get it, y'all.